My friend Renee, who I've done some surgery on, obviously you could see, and we were just talking about people and, you know, how they're married but separated in a way. And so she informed me about her story, and I think this is very cute. So can you tell me a little bit about your marriage and your how you lived and this and
okay.
that?
Okay. I was married to my husband 45 years ago, and we bought a house in Toms River. And I always said, if we ever left that house in Toms River, I would only go east to the ocean, to be closer to the ocean. So, fortunately, I had been going to the same beach, the same house area for 73, now 4 years.
Wow.
I started going to the beach at 6 months old with my parents. They pitched tents to go down there first. So I always said I always wanted to get closer to the beach. Unfortunately, my parents died within the same year, and I inherited the house at the beach. And then I said to my husband, I said, well, that house is not going to sit there empty. Sorry, but I'm going. So I went to the house.
Wonderful.
And I went during the summer because my dad died in February. So the summer came, I went to the beach, and I said to my husband, well, September's really nice at the beach. I think I'm going to stay for September too. And I would go back and forth to Toms River because I did work. So I'd go back, and if he needed groceries, I'd go grocery shopping, whatever. And then that ended up to be 15 years of doing the same thing until my husband did get sick and he could no longer take care of himself. So I did move back into the house in Toms River with him, and then sold the Toms River house once
he
passed.
So how did you? What was your relationship like when he stayed mostly in Toms River, and you stayed mostly on the beach house? But he would come and stay with you at the beach house now?
No, no, because there's not enough room. There's only two bedrooms. I had two kids. They came with me too.
Oh, the kids.
We abandoned him.
So how did you guys continue your relationship? Because, by the way, you don't need to wear this stupid-looking bandage. You just did a procedure on your nose. So how did you guys...
Well...
You never divorced.
No. No. And we never went out with other people. I mean, there was no...
And you loved each other dearly?
Yeah. But we just... We were never that huggy, mushy, gushy, romantic kind of a couple.
I see.
You know, we did our own.
You're busy, like really close friends that were married and cared about each other.
Absolutely.
And wanted to be there together.
Mm-hmm.
And you didn't go out with other men.
Nope.
Did he?
No interest. He had no interest in other people. I didn't have any. It was
And it was a close relationship you had.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Wonderful.
Right. And he had his little issue. He was a doctor. He was an optometrist.
Oh, okay.
So he did a lot of his work during the evening.
I see.
You know, when we were raising the kids and everything else. So had a unique relationship.
Yeah.
However, it worked for both of us.
And it was non-traditional. And that's what life is all about, trying to figure out
how it's
going to
work. Exactly.
In a non-traditional way you could just carry on, right?
And even when I did work and I taught, we talk about this and the other, everybody would always say, you have the perfect relationship going. You're there, he's there, and we were always best of friends and everything else. It was really good.
Wonderful. And you know what? And I told you that one of the reasons I'm doing that is to share people's experiences on my channel under Dr. Rami Geffner on YouTube, okay?
Okay.
And I have other people's experiences on that. And as I retire, which will be tomorrow, I'm going to be collecting very memorable experiences, interviewing people of different walks of life, you know?
Excellent. Mm-hmm. That's really good.
Thanks for sharing this, really.
No problem.
Okay? Thank you so much.